Hi guys, good morning. We are continuing with our CAT papers discussion and now we are going to look at the other half of CAT 2005 maths. We've already done the first half yesterday evening. So let's quickly jump in. Hi, I'm Munira Lokhandwala and I'm Calcutta alumna, a serial 100 percentiler in CAT and a 99 percentiler in GMAT. I also have a CAT verbal book published by Wiley and available on Amazon. Besides the YouTube Unacademy Crack Cat channel. You can also find me on the Unacademy app. So guys, just go to the Play Store, right? To find me in the app, you first need the app on your phone. So just go to the Play Store, search for Unacademy Learning app, install kijiye, and within that, you need to go for the Plus Cat courses, right? You may wonder, okay, why do I need to join a Plus subscription when there's already a lot of free content available? But yes, the free content is a lot of bits and pieces, right? To have a full-fledged proper preparation in place, the Plus CAT channel is where you need to be. Which subscription to go for? Well, we could discuss towards the end of the class. You can use my code MUNIRA10 to get a 10% discount, right? Next, we'll start off with a puzzle that I gave you all yesterday evening. N students in the math club at Dhoni Secondary School. Mrs. Fryer tries to put the N students in groups of four. There's one group with fewer than four students, but all of the other groups are complete. Right? So let's say there are N students. You can rewrite N as a multiple of four plus some remainder. Right? Because one group has fewer than four students. When she tries to put them in groups of three, that same N can be written as three, right? Three times L plus another remainder. So I'm calling this R4 because the remainder with respect to four, this is the remainder that's left when you divide by three. And then finally, she tries to put them in groups of two, and again, she has a remainder. So, clearly when I divide by 4, I could have 3 possible remainders. If there is definitely a remainder, 0 is not possible, right? I could have 1 or 2 or 3. When I'm putting it in groups of 2, the remainder can be 1 or 2. When I'm putting it in groups of 2, right, the remainder can only be 1. That means clearly from here that the number is odd. If the number was even, then, you know, you would not have this incomplete group. When she's putting it in groups of two, there's again one incomplete group. So that means the number is odd. Now the other thing is that when she's putting it in groups of four, let's say she makes X groups of four students, right? X complete groups. These are complete groups. Then when she's putting them in groups of three, she gets three more groups. And when she's putting it in groups of five, she gets five more groups than this, which is eight more groups. Right? Okay. So, you know, four and two, there is a clear relationship better than four and three. So, if this remainder business wouldn't have been there, right? Then, and if I'm just looking at complete groups, then the groups that I can form with four, right? Let's say that's K. We are making K groups of 4. And the groups that I am forming with 2, right, which is M, M should be double of K because 2 is half of 4. Right? Now, if I have, let's say, 64 students, I can make 16 groups of 4 and I can make exactly double of that, of 2, 32 groups of 2. So, the difference, right, the number of groups that I can make of 4 and 2, right, will be in the ratio 1 is to 2. Approximately, because there are remainders. So if this is 8, that means I am looking at approximately 8 groups of 4 and 16 groups of 2. So let's start with a number 33, because it's odd, I can't start with 32, right? 16 groups of 2 means 32, this also means 32, but we want an odd number. So if I start with 33, then let's see the kind of groups I'm making with respect to 4, 3 and 2, and is this relationship being satisfied. So with 4, I'm making 8 groups. Fair enough. With 3, I'm making exactly 11. No remainder. Problem. I need a remainder. Always there is an incomplete group. Never are all groups complete. So 33 cannot be the answer. Now the further I will move, guys, the more groups I will get of 2. So I have to first try for 31. Let's try for 31 first. So how many groups of 4? 7. And I have a remainder, right? Remainder is 3. How many groups of 3? 10. So there is a difference of 3 groups, which is what we want. And I still have a remainder. I have a remainder of 1, which is what we want. We want a remainder. When I divide by 2, I make 15 groups. Great. And I have a remainder of 1, guys. So the answer is, there's a unique answer. It is 31. Correct? Difference of 3, difference of 5, everything is satisfied. You have incomplete groups as well. So your answer is 31. It's not an easy question to do because there is going to be a small amount of trial and error involved. But at least you should reach 32 very easily. And then you can check for 31, you can check for 33, you can check for 35, right? Uske aas paas hi answer hoga. Think about it, no? Logically, if I reach 36, for example, then the number of groups of 4 will be 9 and the number of groups of 2, right, will be 18. And that's a difference of 9. I don't want 9. I want only 8. So 8 ka difference will have to occur around 30. Okay. So your answer is 31. Great. Let's look at the questions. So you have four points A, B, C and D. They lie on a straight line in the XY plane such that AB is equal to BC is equal to CD. So you have A, B, C and D. Right? So this is 1 and they're all equal, so everything is 1. An ant at A wants to reach D, but there are insect repellents at points B and C, so the ant cannot go closer than 1 meter, right? So the ant yahan se will take a circular approach to keep that radius of 1 meter. Once it reaches here, if it goes down, then this distance may no longer be 1. So the best way to maintain a 1 meter distance from B also and C also is to just go straight. Then from here again, the ant will go down to reach D. So I've drawn this I've got a diagram, thankfully. Okay. You can see it here that each of these is 1 centimeter. So BC is 1 centimeter, which means PQ also will be 1 centimeter. So the one way the ant could go is like this, right? Keeping a 1 centimeter distance. And from here, the ant could go down, but again, the ant will have to come up. So, you know, this covering this distance is more than this distance. So, minimum is going to be along the straight line. Minimum is not going to be, you know, the curvy linear form. So, the final path, how will that look? It will move around this. Right? Go straight and then come down. Now definitely you're going to add 1 to your pi answer, right? There's going to be an answer in pi because they are going to go through the circumference and then you're going to add 1 extra. So this is the only possible answer. Isme to pi hai hi nahi, isme sirf pi hai, isme sirf integer hai. You want an integer plus pi form answer. So this is your answer. But if you have to solve also, guys, radius is 1 centimeter, right? This is the radius. And this is quarter of a circle. So this portion, the arc AP plus the arc QD, right, is basically quarter circle plus quarter circle. So you get a semicircle. Now, radius is pi, right? So, you get your full circle is going to be 2 pi r. This is full circle. and your your semicircle is going to be pi r, which with r is equal to 1 becomes only pi. So pi plus 1 is going to be your answer. But as soon as, you know, I saw there's only one option which has an integer also and pi also, I just marked it, right? Next question. If x is greater than or equal to y and y is greater than 1, what is the value of this expression? So can never be, not what is, but can never be. So it can be a lot of values and you have to find one value that it cannot be. Now log here, so it could be 0 also. Generally, I always think it's an extreme value. So it cannot be minus 1 or 1. One of these is going to be our answer because these are extreme, right? When there's a range, it can take a lot of values in the range, but when you reach the extreme point, it cannot take that value. But with log, you know, 0 can also be a problem. So there are three possible answers. Let's solve this, okay? So, first problem is that it is x over y and y over x. It's not simply x, simply y. So, we'll have to just rewrite this, right? That if you have log of x by y to the base x, that's the same as log of x to the base x minus log of y to the base x. So, please remember, guys, what does log give? Log gives you the index. And when you divide, like if you have 2 raised to 8 by 2 raised to 5, what is it actually? It is 2 raised to 8 minus 5. So division in logs actually becomes subtraction. Right? Because this will be 8, this will be 5, the answer will be 3. Okay? So, ye aap subtract kar loge, and then similarly, the second part also is log of y to the base y. Minus, because there's a division here also, right? Log of x to the base y. Now, what do I need x? What do I need to raise x to get x as the answer? This has to be 1, right? So, a number to the same base is always 1. This is 1. This is 1, right? So, you will get, if I just get that together, you will get 2. So, you'll get 2 minus of log of y to the base x minus of log x to the base y. Right? Now, if 2 cubed is 8, 8 raised to what is 2? It is 8 raised to 1 by 3. That is why, guys, y to the base x and x to the base y will be reciprocals of each other. Okay? So, I can write this as 2 minus of x. X is already used. Let's say a minus 1 by a. So, this part is going to be reciprocal of this part. Right? Now, this is positive because x is more than y and y is greater than 1. So, I can rewrite this as 2 minus of root a the whole square minus of 1 by root a the whole square. So minus outside, I can rewrite this as root a the whole square because a minus bahar aa gaya. But now 2 becomes minus because 2 was originally plus. And plus root of 1 by root of a square. So this is nothing but root of a minus 1 by root of a the whole square. Now, this part will always be positive. And with a minus, this will be negative or it will be 0. It is never going to be positive. This full thing is never going to be positive because inside it's always going to be 0 or positive. So, outside it's going to be 0 or negative. So, that's your answer option 4 because this can never be positive, right? Great. Next question. For a positive integer n, let Pn denote the product of the digits of n and s, right? So, I can write this like this. Pn is equal to n minus Sn. Now, in life, not just for cat, in life, when you see some of the digits of a number, you must always think that somewhere 9 is involved. So here also, n ka jo remainder hai 9 ke saath, right? The remainder of n with respect to 9 is going to come from the sum of the digits. So n minus sn will always be a multiple of 9, will always be a multiple of 9. Because jo remainder n ka hai, wohi remainder sn ka hai. So remainder cancel ho jayega. Think about it. No, any number you pick up, yeah. Pick up a 5-digit number also. Like 7, 5, 1, 2, I don't want this to be 1 to 4. So what is the number itself? It's 7, 5, 1, 2, 4. From this, if I subtract the sum, which is 12 and 7, 19. What am I left with? 7, 5, 1, 0, 5. Now, if you just check this, this is a multiple of 9. It has to happen. So, if the product of digits is a multiple of 9, then most probably there is a 9 somewhere, no? So, product can also be, if a 2-digit number can also be 3 into 3, 9. But basically, the number has to have a 9 in the unit's digit. From here, I started thinking, right, that it has to have a 9 in the unit's digit. So, I get a higher product and the number is still small. Think about it, right? Compare 19 with 91. The product is the same, but this number is very small. This number is big. So, there has to be a 9 in the unit's place. Okay. So, now let's check 19. Is 19 equal to the product plus the sum of the digits? Yes, it is. Is 29 equal to the product plus the sum of the digits? Yes, it is. 39. Yes, it will be. Till 99, this will be true. So, 9 options you get from here only. Now, how about a 3-digit number? So, you again, you know, let's look at the largest 3-digit number possible, 999. Iska product be 729 is just too far away from this number. Any number you take, like 299 also, what is the product? 162, it is too far away from this number. So if you just do the maths also, right? You have to write 100A, the number is ABC, right? Then the number is 100A plus 10B plus 10C as ABC product plus sum of the digits. So the product has to be equal to 99A plus 9B. Right? Now, whatever the number is, 99A can we get? Two digits also, if I multiply, the maximum I get is 81. Right? So, if you just think about this a little bit more, just divide the whole thing with A, you get 99 plus 9B by A is equal to BC. Now BC can max be 81. So how will I get 99? Not possible. So for 3-digit number, it's not possible. For 2-digit numbers, there are 9 possibilities. So the answer is 4th option, which is 9. Right? Great. Next. Rectangular tiles, each of size 70 into 30, must be laid horizontally on a rectangular floor. So this is your big floor. 110 yaha pe hai, 130 yaha pe hai. It should be completely contained in this floor. Nothing should fall outside. No overshooting. And I want to maximize how many 70 into 30 I can place. So one way is ke, you know, just place 30 idhar. So 1, 2, so I have used up 60. Right, then 3. Then 4, 120 used up, cannot put in more. Okay. Phir, how much is left here? Here 70, this is 70, right? 70 into 30. So this is 70. So this is 40. So I can put only 1 here because 30 into 70, if I put 2, Then I need 140, which I do not have. So it seems as if the answer is 5. But it can't be that easy, no? Maybe there are other ways to put it. So what if I don't place them like this, okay? What if I try to use the full 130? Can I use the full 130 in some way or the other? So to use 130, I can place one of the 70s here. So 70, right? This is 70 and this is 30. And now 60 is left. From 130, I have used 70, 60 is left. I can put two more tiles here of 30. So this is 30, 30, 60 and 70. 130 I have used up. And I have put three tiles. Now, on this side, I still have 80 left. So I can put two tiles of 70. And this is 30, 30. So I can easily, ye to 70 use kar raha hai na. This much is 70. So I can easily put two more tiles. And then in the remaining 70, I can put the third tile here also. So there's a, this much space is wasted, but I can put six tiles, three here, one first tile, second tile, third tile, fourth tile, fifth tile, and sixth tile. So I've, this is a neater diagram I have. You can look at this diagram. Right, that here you have 110 all used up as 70 with these two tiles, a small gap of 10 and 30 with this sleeping tile, 70 with the standing tiles. Similarly, 70 here with the sleeping tile, 70 with these two standing tiles and a gap of 10. So it's symmetrical in some sense. Right, if you rotate it, you will get some symmetry axis and you can put in six tiles. So answer is not 4, not 5, answer is 6. Yeah, great. Next question. In the xy plane, the area of the region bounded by the graph mod of x plus y plus mod of x minus y is 4 is. Okay. So the thing is, guys, that mod functions change the way they behave based on whether a mod ke andar positive hai ya negative hai. Okay. So let me just draw the xy axis. This is the y axis. This is the x axis. Wow. that pen ran. Now if I draw this line, not bad. This is the line x is equal to y. Okay. Any point on this side, right, is such that x is less than y, which means x minus y is negative. And any point here is such that x minus y is positive. So on this side of the line, mod x minus y will be actually y minus x, and on this side it will be x minus y. Okay. Similarly, now if I draw this line here, x is equal to minus y. This is the line x is equal to minus y. Right? On this side, x plus y is positive. Okay. So we have four regions. Okay. This is the first region. Let me call this region A. This is the second region B. This is the third region C, and this is the fourth region D. So really I'm doing this right from basics because modulus is very popular in the CAT, guys, and this will help you in other questions also. So in region A, what is happening? Let's see at region A. Yaha pe x minus y is negative. and x plus y is positive. This whole x plus y is positive for region A also and D also. X plus y is negative for region B and region C. So when I have a function like modulus of x plus y plus modulus of x minus y. So if the modulus ke andar jo hai negative hai, toh you will multiply it with minus 1 to make it positive. So x minus y becomes y minus x and x plus y remains x plus y because it is positive already. So this is equal to 4. X and x cancels off and you get 2y is equal to 4, y is equal to 2. So in this region, this is your line. Y is equal to 2. Okay. Now what happens in region B? In region B, guys, you have x minus y is still negative. In A and B, x minus y is negative. And you will have x plus y also as negative. Which means when you open up the brackets, you have to multiply both of them by 0. Minus x minus y. And y minus x is equal to 4. So now y is cancelling off. And you have x is equal to minus 2. So this is your... So now you are getting a sense of what this will work out to. Similarly, here you will get y is equal to minus 2. And finally, on this side, you will get x is equal to plus 2. So the region bounded by the graph is basically a square of side 4. Right? You can see that the side is 4. From minus 2 to plus 2 and from plus 2 to minus 2, side is 4. So area will be 16. Right? Actually got this done here so that, you know, we can see what is happening. Let me just go through it again quickly here. So for those of you who didn't get it, right? That in this red line, which is the line x equal to y. So it is the line x minus y is equal to 0. So on one side of the line, you will have x minus y is less than 0. And on the other side, you have more than 0. If you are confused, konsa hai, toh just put the line 0, just put the point 0, 1. When I put 0, 1 here, I get negative. So the top of the red line, right? When you look at the top of the red line, x minus y is negative. And bottom is x minus y is positive. So put this point to find out, right? Put the point 3, 0 in x minus y. You will see it's positive. Whereas the blue line, you can say top of the blue line is x plus y is positive. Any point you put here, right? X plus y will be positive. And bottom is when x plus y is negative. So when you put these equations, you will get that y is equal to 2. Here you will get x is equal to 2. Here you will get y is equal to minus 2. And here you will get x is equal to minus 2. So this is going to be a region, right? Next question, guys. Diameter of the circle is 3 cm. AB and MN are two diameters such that MN is perpendicular to AB. So first of all, what is O, guys? Whenever two diameters intersect, they intersect at the center. So O is your center. Okay. In addition, CG is perpendicular to AB. So this is already perpendicular given, right? And this is also perpendicular. And AE is 1. So AB, the full AB is 3 cm. It's a diameter, right? Diameter is 3 cm. Out of which I'm breaking it up in the ratio 1 is to 2. So AE is 1. OE is 0.5 because the radius is 1.5. And OB is 1.5. Right? So EB fully is 2. Now if OE is 0.5, HL will also be 0.5 because it is parallel. It's like a rectangle. Right? CG is also perpendicular. And DF is also perpendicular. So your HEOL is a rectangle. So 0.5, 0.5. Right? E, and you have the same relationship here also, that NL is equal to 1, LM is equal to 2, so this is also 0.5 and this is also 0.5. Okay, now we want to find DH. We know OD, guys. Do we know OD? OD is the radius. So we know OD. OD is 3 by 2, 1.5. Do we know OL? Yes, we know OL, that is half, 0.5. Can I find DL? Yes, using Pythagoras I can. Do I know HL? Yes, HL is half. So can I find DH? Yes, we can. That's what we need to do basically. Okay, so let's start off. OD is basically 3 by 2. So, OD square is equal to OL square plus DL square, right? So, I'll get 9 by 4 is equal to 1 by 4 plus DL square. So, DL square is equal to 2, right? It's 8 by 4, so it's equal to 2. DL is equal to root 2. Now, DL is root 2. What is DH? It is DL minus HL, which is root 2 minus half. So that is 2 root 2 minus 1 divided by 2. Second option. Right? Let's look at the next question. 23. Consider the triangle ABC where BC is equal to 12 and DB is equal to 9. BCD is equal to BAC. Angle. Okay, so BCD, this angle is equal to this angle. So guys, whenever you know you have some angle equal, whenever you have a triangle within a triangle, you must always think of similarity. So what do I need for similarity? I need two angles to be equal. The third angle will automatically be equal. So let us look at the triangle BBC and the triangle BAC. So angle B, ek angle to same hai dono mein, which is angle B. This is the same in both the triangles. And then these two angles are equal. So the third angle, this angle has to be equal to this angle actually. Okay, so now just let's get the point of similarity. Let's do vertex symmetry, right? So B is symmetrical to B because it's the same angle. C is symmetrical to A. So it is B, C and B, A. And the remaining is D. And here the remaining is C. This is how the similarity works. Okay, now I already have the perimeter of BDC. I now need to find 1 and 2. DC already have an ADC. Okay. So, let's write down the first statement that BC over BD, BC over BD is equal to BA over BC. So, what will I get? What is BC, guys? It is 12 divided by 9 is equal to BA divided by 12. So 4 by 3. This is also 4 by 3, which means BA is 16. Which means AD is 7, right? Because BD is 9 and BA is 16. So this is 7. Now I need to find AC. So I will say DC over BC. Correct? So DC over BC is equal to AC over BC. So what is DC? It is 6 by 12 Oh, wait, I'm looking at the wrong triangle. That's what I'm wondering, right? Yeah, so I want AC. So I will say CD over BD is equal to AC over BC. That's right. So what is CD? It is 6 by 12 is equal to what is AC wave supposed to find out. And BC is 12. And BD is actually 9. Yeah. So you have 2 by 3 and this also has to be 2 by 3. So AC will have to be 8. So AC is 8. So the perimeter of ADC, guys, is 6 plus 7 plus 8. And the perimeter of BDC is 9 plus 6 plus 12. So you have 21 by 27. You have 7 by 9. Right? Next question. PQRS are points on the circumference of a circle of radius R such that PQR is an equilateral triangle and PS is a diameter of the circle. So you have a circle and you have an equilateral triangle and you have the diameter also like this. P, S and this is Q and R. Right, so I've just drawn this here to make our lives better. Yeah. So the radius is given. Let's call this point X. So XR is equal to XQ is equal to your radius, small r. Now this is an equilateral triangle, PQ, correct? And if the equilateral triangle is angle 60 degrees inside the arc, right? Then the central angle has to be 120. And since both of these are equal sides, it has to be 30 and 30. Right? Now, if you just check triangle X, Q and R, it is congruent to triangle S, Q and R. Right? Why? Because you have a common side. And you have common angle of 120. 120 and 120. So you can see the 120, guys, if I draw the line PS as the diameter, PQS, right? PQS, it has to be a right angle triangle because it is inscribed in the diameter. So it is 90 degrees. Out of which PQR is 60. So, RQS will have to be 30. So, right, you can see this is 30, this is 30, and there is a common side. So, these two triangles should be congruent. So, SQ is equal to SR should also be equal to the small r. So, I'm definitely adding 2R. Right, so second option is gone, third option is gone, it is fourth or first. Now, if I focus on triangle XQ, right, and let's call this midpoint here Y, XQ and Y, then the hypotenuse is R and the side opposite 60, which is QY, will be R into root 3 by 2, 30, 60, 90, right, which means the full QR will be R root 3. So now all three sides, right? PQ is equal to QR is equal to PR is equal to R root 3. So now if I want to find the perimeter of the quadrilateral P, Q, S and R, that is nothing but PQ plus QS plus SR plus PR. PQ is root 3, QS is 1, SR or R rather, right? This is root 3R, this is R, this is R, and this is also root 3R. So you will get 2R into root 3, and then you will get 2R. So we are looking at option 1, right? Next question. Let S be a set of positive integers. every digit of S is odd, which means that I cannot have 1 0. I have to start with 1 1. I cannot even have 1 2. So all numbers are going to be of the form 1 1 AB, where A and B are odd. And 1 plus 1 plus A plus B is a multiple of 3. Then only the number becomes a multiple of 3. Right? So that's the first thing, guys, that your, of course, your thousands is fixed at 1. But even your hundreds is fixed at 1, because your 100 cannot be 0, cannot be 2. Every digit is odd. Right? Now, what are the values A plus B can take? A plus B can take 4, smallest value. A plus B cannot be 1 because they are both odd. They have to be at least 2, right? So 1 plus 1, A plus B is 4. And since A and B are both odd, guys, A plus B will be even. So A plus B, for example, cannot be 7. Even if 1 plus 1 plus 7 is a multiple of 3, A plus B cannot be 7 because A and B are odd and A plus B has to be even. So A plus B can be 4, A plus B can be 10. And then A plus B can be 16. So now when A plus B is 4 and both the digits are odd, you get two possibilities, 1, 3 and 3, 1. Then when A plus B is 10 and both the digits are odd, you get 1, 9, 9, 1, 3, 7, 7, 3 and you get 5, 5. And then when A plus B is 16, you get two possibilities, 7, 9, 9, 7. So 2 and 5, you have 9 possibilities totally. Right? Next question. So I remember seeing this for the CAT and I knew that, you know, this is going to lead to a fourth order equation. So I just approximated. Right? Let's say the answer is 3. Okay. If the answer is 3, then you will get x is equal to root of 4, right? Now, this keeps repeating, guys. 4 plus 4 minus, right? Then again, 4 plus 4 minus. So, jo bhi x hai, this also has to be x because it's infinity. So, this just keeps repeating, right? Which means that if x is 3, then this part should also be 3. So, I substituted 3. Okay, 4 plus root of 4 minus 3. So this becomes 1, so I get root 5, which is not equal to 3. So this is gone. 3 is not possible. Okay, abhi 3 tha, so I substituted integer. Now substituting all this is painful. All of these. So then I said, okay, let me just approximate. Answer is going to be a little more than 2, between 2, 2.5 or something. Why? Because I can see it is 4 plus a positive number. So if I put 2 also, for example, that x is 2, then I get 4 plus root 2. So I'll get around 5 point something, right? So the answer has to be close to around 2.1, 2.2, more, a little more than 2. Okay. Now what is root 13? So 13 is between 9 and 16, right? Uske beech mein aata hai 13. Agar 9 hota hai, to answer would be 3. Agar 16 hota hai root mein, to answer would be 4. 13 beech mein, so it will be close to 3.5. Okay. If we get close answers, then I'm going to get deeper into this. Otherwise, I'm not going to care. So now I just substituted 13 is equal to root 13 as 3.5. And I'm seeing which answer gives me something a little more than 2. Right? So, okay. 3.5 minus 1 divided by 2. I get 1 point something. Blah, blah. Not possible. Right? 2.5 my divided by 2 is what I get. So it's 1 point something. So second option out. This is 3.5 plus 1 divided by 2. 4.5 divided by 2. This is looking very good. A little more than 2. Let's keep this. And this is too big. It is 3.5 itself. So answer is third option. Right? Great. Next question. Let g of x be a function such that g of x is the sum of the terms around it. So what I did was, instead of getting into the function bit, I said, let me make my own function. It has to be true, no? Kuch bhi hoga, it has to be true. सो आई सेड ओके, माइनस वन है, जीरो है और वन है. सो आई एम सेइंग कि जीरो इज इक्वल टू वन प्लस ऑफ माइनस वन, राइट. सो दिस इज एक्स माइनस वन, दिस इज एक्स एंड दिस इज एक्स प्लस वन, उसका जी, राइट. ओके, नाउ टू फाइंड द नेक्स्ट वन, द मिडिल टर्म इज द सम ऑफ द टर्म्स अराउंड इट. सो वन इज द सम ऑफ जीरो एंड वन. This middle term, 1, is the sum of 1 and 0. Then, you may think, yeah, ye repetition ho gaya hai, correct? But, they two terms have to repeat for something like this to repeat. A single term need not repeat, warna toh yahan pe repetition ho jata. So, are two terms repeating? Minus 1, 0. 1, 0. Two terms are not repeating. Okay, so if 0 is the middle term, 0 is the sum of this and this, so this is minus 1. Now again, minus 1 is the sum of this number and this number, so this also has to be minus 1. And then minus 1 again is the sum of this number and this number, so this number is 0. And now you can see two terms are repeating. So now it will start. Again, yahan pe 1 aayega, again yahan pe 1 aayega. The repetition will properly start. So, कितने टाइम के बाद did I get my zero वाला repetition? After 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, answer is 6. Okay? So guys, I hope you understood, right? I just picked up my own numbers and you don't even need to pick up minus 1, 0, 1. I like smaller numbers, so I pick them up. You can pick up any number. You can do the same thing by picking up, let us say, 1, 1 and beech mein you have 2. So the middle term is the sum of the terms around it, right? So now what will this number be? It has to be the 1 is the sum of 2 and something. So, that has to be minus 1. Now, I've got minus 1 here, which is the sum of 1 plus something. So, that has to be minus 2. Then, minus 1 and minus 1 will give me minus 2. And then, plus 1 and minus 2 will give me minus 1. And then plus 2 with minus 1 will give me 1. And now you can, again, right? It doesn't matter which numbers you take. But this is far easier than actually sitting down and doing some convoluted equations with g of x minus 1, g of x plus 1, right? So great, let's look at the next question. A telecom service operator provides male and female operators for answering 1000 calls per day. A male operator can handle 40, female can handle 50. Male get a fixed wage of 250, female gets a fixed wage of 300 for just landing up. Okay, so it's a fixed wage. Then per call the male gets 15, female gets 10. So minimize the total cost. So you will pick up whoever is cheaper. So I need to find out how much do I need to pay a male for coming to work and making 40 calls. So how much do we need to pay the male? You have to pay 250, the fixed charge, plus 15 into 40. So you have to pay a male 250 plus 600, 850 rupees per day. And what is the male doing? He's doing only 40 calls. For females, it is going to be 300 fixed plus 50 calls, her call 10 rupee ka. So you are paying 800, right? And you have to get 50 calls done with this 800. So definitely females are cheaper. So if 12 female operators are available for the job, I'll take all 12 because they're cheaper. I want to minimize the total cost. So these 12 females can do 600 calls. I have to get 1000 calls done. So 400 calls are still left. each male does 40. So 400 calls ke liye, I will need 10 males. Option 4. Right? Great. 29th. You have 3 Englishmen. So you have 1 circle of influence here. Right? This is the Englishman who knows French. So I'm writing EF. And these are the other 2 Englishmen. This is one of the anyone French guy, and these are the, because nobody knows English, right? But because this guy knows French, he can talk to him in French, he can tell his secrets in French, and this guy can just talk to him in French and get his secrets, and this guy will be able to translate, okay? So each one of them knows a secret, and now everyone has to know the secrets, and you want minimum phone calls because ISD is still expensive. This is one of those earlier years when international calling was expensive. Okay. So, these guys have to talk to each other. But before they talk, they have to know the secrets of the full gang. So, 2 calls will go when these 2 guys just tell him the secrets. So, now EF knows all 3 English secrets in 2 calls. Similarly, in 2 calls, this French guy will know all French secrets. So now they both know the 3 secrets. They will call each other. Okay. So 2 calls plus 2 calls plus 1 call. After which, both these guys now know 6 secrets because they have spoken to each other. In 5 calls, they both 2 guys know 6 secrets. But ye dono ka kya? Ye dono ka kya? So now this English guy will make 2 calls and he'll tell both of these fellows all the secrets. And the French guy will make 2 calls and tell all the secrets. So answer is going to be 2 plus 2 plus 1 plus 2 plus 2, which is 3rd option. Right? Great. A rectangular floor is fully covered with square tiles of identical size. The tiles on the edge are white and the tiles in the interior are red. The number of white tiles is the same as the number of red tiles. A possible value of the number of tiles along one edge of the floor is. So it looks like one of those absolutely filthy equation questions, right? That you start with length into breadth, and then, you know, you remove a whole slice here of tiles. So under ka rectangle, right, this rectangle is going to be L minus 2 because you're removing, you know, one set of tiles from here, one set of tiles from here. And your breath also has to, you know, remove one. And it just looks horrible. Who in his or her right mind will do all this? And this, right, the middle part and the outer part is the same. So you have this equation. Half. No, half is here. And then you sit and solve this. I'm not solving this. So you know what I was thinking is this, that let's say that I don't want the half. Okay. Let's say that you start with a particular length. Let's say the length is 10. Ab ye jo andar ka length hai, right, will be 8. So, your length decreases in the ratio 5:4. Now, if the area has to be constant, see, I know the area has to become half, huh? But if the area was supposed to remain constant, your breadth would have gone up in the ratio 4:5. Then the area would have been constant, right? Length into breadth will be constant if they behave in inverse proportion. So, if length decreases, why am I looking at 10? Because ek option hai. And how will n decrease? Because I'm subtracting 2 from it on both the sides, right? We're subtracting these tiles. So it will decrease to 8. So the length is decreasing in the ratio 5:4. So if I want it to be constant, the breadth should increase in the ratio 4:5. But it is not constant. It has to become half. So this 5 should become 2.5. Then you can see here the product is 20 and here the product is 10. It has become half. Now 4:2.5 is how the breadth should change, which is a difference of 1.5. But what difference do I want in the tiles? I want even in the breadth the difference to be 2. So 1.5 cannot be translated to a 2. So 10 is not an answer. View. No equation, nothing. Let's start with 12. Where is my pen? Okay, here it is. If 12 is your length, then -2 becomes 10. That means there's a decrease in the ratio 6:5. So if it was constant, the breadth should increase in the ratio 5:6. But it is not constant. This has to become half. So this 6 will become 3. And you can straight away see, isn't it lovely? 5 and 3, the difference is 2. Right, so if you now check, you start with 12 and 5, the product is 60. 12 se 2 kam kiya, 10, 5 se 2 kam kiya, 3, the product becomes 30. 30 is half of 60, it is perfect. Answer is option 2. You don't even need to check because you've got a possible value. But just for fun, just to see, right, that no other option fits in and very few option will. 14 agar answer hai, toh -2 is 12. 7:6 ke ratio mein decrease kiya hai, 6:7 ke ratio mein increase karega. If it was constant, but it's not, so this becomes 3.5, half of 7. This difference of 2.5 cannot be translated to a difference of 2. So, gone. 16 becomes 14, so 8:7. So, 7:8, but 8 should become half and become 4. This difference of 3 cannot become a difference of 2. So, only possible is 12, right? So I hope, guys, that you all enjoyed the way we solve these questions and the lovely methods that we followed, right? Here is your puzzle. Again, very interesting puzzle. Each integer from 1 to 2 is to be placed around the outside circle so that, oops, so that the difference between any two is at most 2. For example, yahan pe I can put 2 or 3 or 4, around 4, of course, 4 cannot, 5 or 6, right? So difference, I cannot put 1 because then the difference becomes 3. I cannot put 7, right? I can put any of these. Now 3 is already here, so you know, I can only put any. So this is the way in which you have to start thinking. You have to find the value of x plus y, right? Here is your reading assignment, guys. We all know war has a lot of issues with it. This is for the Vietnam War, morality of the Vietnam War. It's a good article, guys. Please read it. I'll see you again when we do 2004 reading comprehension in the evening. And I'll see you again on Unacademy, guys. Please just look at this great environment that you have in which to study. CAT ke liye abhi only 75 days or so are left. Do not waste time. Please go and subscribe. Please become a user. You take our test, you get great and quick national ranks, right? So get your doubts solved, get everything done. Which subscription to go for, guys? If you're focused on CAT 20, you can look at the 12-month subscription because XAT, CET, SNAP, there are a lot of things that will keep coming one after the other. And the cost differential is very less. Between a 6-month and a 12-month, you're just paying 3,500 extra, right? If you're looking at CAT 20 or 21, then you can look at the 24-month program. You can use my code MUNIRA10 to get a 10% discount. And you can see this price is far, far less than anything you will see online with any of the other classes, right? So great. I'll see you soon. Take care. Bye-bye.